Oh,
hello. It is now 7 p.m. The ballot, the election is complete. There is nobody waiting in the queue. So we are just going to finish up anybody who is in line.
I don't think this is on. I don't think it is.
So right now, it's 7 o'clock. I'm just declaring the polls have officially closed. Okay. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Richard E. Rennie, your moderator for the 2015 annual meeting of the Hampton Beach Village District. Again, it is now 7 p.m. The polls have now closed. A ballot count for election of village district offices will now take place, and the results announced upon completion. Before we begin the discussion on the warrants, as we have done in the past, to ensure a valid and accurate count taken on the warrant articles. This is where things get a little, you're gonna be disturbed a little bit. Proceed to the table of the supervisors of the checklist. That's the table over here. And you'll see that there are three divisions. Alphabet A through H, I through O, and P through Z. Form a queue line in front of that alphabet, state your name, present a valid picture ID, and you will obtain from the supervisors a green card. This will be used when you vote during your proceedings. Additionally, I am requesting that non-village district residents take a seat to my left, an area to my left. When we discuss Article 2, that requires a ballot vote and a two-third majority, I will explain that process, because again, it is a ballot vote, and it's going to be conducted a little different than just showing your cards. So please, retain control of those cards. So again, if you all proceed, again, I'm sorry to disturb you, but this is the way the process has to go. Queue up, identify. Oh, all right, man. Hold on a second. Supervisors are not quite ready yet. 5 minutes. In the meantime, please turn off all the electronic devices. No devices in case of emergency.
Nobody can hear them. Come from the
Oh, this can help.
Okay, everybody who is qualified has a green card, I assume. All right. Assembly of village district residents and a quorum being present, the warrant being duly and properly posted, I call this meeting to order at 7:17. Would you please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance and remain standing? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please remain standing. At this time, I am asking for a moment of silence and reflection in memory of those district residents passed away since our last meeting, namely Joe Hurley, Judy Preston, and Martin Baycock. And if anybody else that you can think of that has passed away, and I'm sorry that I was remiss in getting their names. Thank you. And you can be seated now. Thank you. Introduction of those people here at the head table. I thought somebody was talking to me. On my far right, Chuck Rage, one of our commissioners,
Sharon Summers, legal counsel, and I am Richard Renia, Maureen Buckley, commissioner, Bob Ladd, commissioner, Steve LeBranch, our treasurer, and Joan Rice, our recording secretary. And I notice that also attending this evening, over to the left of where I'm standing, is Mary Louise Worsley from the Board of Selectmen of the Town of Hampton, Fred Rice, our state representative, the chairman of the Board of Selectmen, Rick Griffin, and I notice a few members of the Budget Committee. I will be remiss, and hopefully I don't miss anybody. Mike Clough, Tim Jones, Mike Pierce, and at the back of the building, back of the room, I see John Nyan, the chairman of the Hampton Beach
Commission.
Before we continue, the question of allowing non-district residents to participate in our discussions requires resolution. However, any motion, amendments, or votes, as always, are restricted to village district residents. I will entertain a motion to allow non-district residents to address the body upon recognition by the moderator after all others have had ample opportunity to speak. Do I have a motion and a second?
I'll make that motion.
A motion made by Chuck Rage, seconded by Maureen Buckley. All those in favor of allowing non-district residents to participate in our discussions, raise your green cards. There we go. I conclude that there is a majority of vote, and that will allow the non-residents to speak as if they choose to. The rules of the proceedings. I will read the warrant article, ask for a motion and second, and open the article for discussion. All questions are to be directed to the moderator. If you wish to speak, stand for recognition by the moderator, proceed to the microphone, state your name and address, and voice your comments and questions. I will allow a reasonable time for each speaker. However, I will exercise my responsibilities to maintain a civil and orderly decorum. No amendments will be accepted until, in my opinion, the main motion has been fully discussed. Amendments must be in writing and presented to the moderator for proper recording. Please focus on the content of the article and possible amendments and refrain from personal comments. This is your meeting, and the determination of the moderator may be overruled. Voting will be conducted by raising your cards and counted by myself and an assistant who I have duly sworn in for that purpose. We will now proceed to the warrant articles. First, we need a motion to take Article 3 out of order and vote on that article first. Do I have a motion and a second?
Make the motion, Mr. Moderator. Walter
Kevlin,
10 Fellows Avenue. Make the motion. Second by,
yeah. All right, a motion has been made by Walter Kevlin and seconded by Mike Buckley to move Article 3 in priority over the other articles. Now, all of you have picked up here the town budget, the village district budget, and copies of the articles. So I'm going to read Article 3, and then we will discuss it. To see if the district will pursue to RSA 452:6, vote to add to the list of authorized purposes the purpose of maintenance of activities for recreational purposes, and further to ratify all past actions of the district to maintain activities for recreational purposes. A motion has been made on that article. We will now open it for discussion, and I'm going to call on our legal counsel, Sharon Summers, to elaborate.
I'm short. Can everyone hear me? Is this working?
Is it on?
All right, I'll just.
Should be.
It doesn't seem to be working, so I'll just talk into this. Can everybody hear me? All right. My name is Sharon Summers. I'm the attorney for the precinct, and I want to talk to you a little bit about Article 3 and what this is all about. I want to start with Article 2 is the bond article. And in order to be able to talk about and or possibly pass this bond, The village precinct needs to be able to have the authority to do that. A village precinct, as you probably know, has very limited powers. And in order to be able to exercise certain limited powers, New Hampshire law requires that the precinct take a vote to pass certain things. Now, what happened is that when we put the bond article on the vote, because the precinct's been around for over a century and the records are kind of, you know, part of them are up in the state, part of them are down here, it wasn't really clear that the precinct had taken the necessary votes to do certain things. So out of an abundance of caution, we put Article 3 on the warrant. Well, what happened is that the commissioners instructed my office to do a little bit of historical research on what the precinct had done over the years in terms of passing various laws and taking various votes. And if anyone's interested, I brought a couple of copies of our research along with me tonight. They're over on the corner of the table, and you can take a look at that. But for purposes of this discussion tonight, the important thing that we learned is that this precinct has, in the past, in 1907 and in 1931 and then in 1992, taken votes to authorize you to do certain things. And in 1992, what you did was to vote to authorize yourself to maintain activities for recreational purposes. And that includes appropriating monies for things that you've done basically since 1939. I don't know why it took you until 1992 to pass the warrant article, but nonetheless, the important thing is that you passed it. So the net result of all of this is that Article 3 is a warrant article which asks you to give yourself the authority to maintain recreational activities. You have, as a practical matter, already passed that warrant article back in 1992. So you, in effect, have done the work already. And so my recommendation to you is that you simply, you have to take a vote legally because this is now on the warrant. But my recommendation is that you simply take a vote on this warrant, pass it, and that way it'll be consistent with your past actions really since 1939 in maintaining recreational activities. So I realize that's kind of a long and convoluted explanation, but the bottom line is that we've concluded what your records are. You have the authority to do this. I think if you simply take a vote yes on this, then we can move on to Article 2, which is the bond. I'd be happy to answer any questions that you may have.
Excuse me. If you have a comment, please step forward to the microphone, state your name and address, and make your comments.
Timothy Citizen Jones, 16 Dustin Avenue, Hampton, New Hampshire. Mr. Moderator, I understood the prior speaker asked the questions, and I'm really asking a clarification question of whether she was supporting the motion to remove this warrant article.
You wish to respond? Or?
Sure. Actually, the motion was to move the order of the warrant article, not to remove the warrant article.
Who's asking if we can just remove the warrant?
You cannot.
No. I apparently am confused. I thought the motion was to remove the warrant article.
So take it out of order.
Simply to move it in outside of numerical order, right?
That's what the motion was, and that was the second on that.
Thank you for clarifying my question. I'll be prepared to make my comments whenever the moderator wishes me to.
All right, so we are now going to take a vote.
No, I haven't made my comments yet.
We're not ready to do that yet. We are, the motion on the floor is to move this article out of order.
Oh, okay.
Then we will discuss the article.
Okay.
All those in favor of allowing this article to be moved out of order, raise your green cards. Again, my observations are that the majority of those present are voting in favor of it. Now, we will now take up Article 2. Article 3. We are now going to continue with Article 3. It has been moved out of order. Do I have a motion now on Article 3? A motion has been made by Walter Kevlin to...
Move the question.
To approve Article 3, and also seconded by Mr. Buckley.
By motion, now, Mr. Moderator, is to move the question.
Moving the question requires a two-thirds vote and is not open for discussion. All those in favor of moving the question on Article 3, please signify by raising your cards. Again, my observations are the majority rules that we will now move the question and move on to another article.
Mr. Moderator, a parliamentary inquiry, please.
Yes, sir.
Is it the moderator's intention to deny all comment on all warrant articles or just this preceding one?
This was the only article that so far that has been moved to move the question. So I assume that as we proceed, we will continue with the same process.
So you're happy to allow the minority to not speak?
Thank you.
I know to move the question, but then you need to take the vote. You need to vote on it.
All right, so the article has been moved, a motion was made to move the question to end further discussion on it. Now we will take a vote on Article 3. All those in favor of Article 3, please raise your cards. Again, my observation shows that a majority of rule on Article 3 to be approved as written. Right?
Yes.
Okay. We will now move to Article 2. Yes.
I did not read.
Well, when they finish, I'm not going to mention it, say it's not Article 1 yet, because the ballot counting is still going on the election of officers. Article 2, to see if the district will vote to raise and appropriate the sum of $1 million for the purpose of funding all costs associated with the purchase, acquisition, and development of four pieces of property. Number one, tax map and lot 296/166/1, situated at 164 Ashworth Avenue. Number two, tax map and lot 296/167/1, situated at 166 Ashworth Avenue. Number three, tax map and lot 293/1721, situated at 168 Ashworth Avenue. And four, tax map and lot 296/3/1, situated at 170 Ashworth Avenue. All in Hampton, New Hampshire, and for the construction of a parking lot on said land, to serve the needs of a village district and to authorize the issuance of not more than $1 million of bonds and notes. $1 million, such sum to be raised for the issuance of bonds or notes under and in compliance with the Municipal Finance Act, RSA 33:1, as set forth, what's the term?
Close enough.
As amended, and to authorize the commissioners to apply for, obtain, and accept federal, state, or other local aid, or other aid, if any, which may be available for said project, and to comply with all the laws applicable to said project, to authorize the commissioners to issue, negotiate, sell, and deliver said bonds and notes, and to determine the rate of interest thereon, and the maturity of other terms thereof, and to authorize the commissioners to take any action or to pass any other vote relative thereto. In accordance with the provisions of RSA 33:A-a, a public hearing was held on this matter on February 11, 2015, at the Hampton Beach Fire Station. This matter requires two-thirds vote by ballot, and all voters present and voting at the annual meeting of March 27, 2015. Passage of this article is contingent on the passage of Article 3, to formally add maintenance of activity for recreational purposes to the list of approved purposes for the district. Do I have a motion on Article 2?
Seeing no discussion, Walter Kimball, 10 Fellows Avenue, I move the question.
We have, well, I mentioned earlier that the it was up to the discretion of the moderator to use his discretion to determine whether or not adequate discussion has been made.
Mr. Moderator, we had a public hearing on this on February 11, 2015. You asked if there were any questions. There was no movement in the room. I make a motion to move the question.
Do I have a second on moving the question?
No second.
Second by Mike Buckley. Motion made by Walter Kelman and seconded by Michael Buckley to move the question. Mr. Jones, where are you going?
I have a parliamentary inquiry, Mr. Moderator.
Go ahead.
The motion to move the question cannot be entertained until first you've opened the question to discussion, which has not occurred yet. But that's just a mere legality. I understand.
Well, I asked initially, was there any...
apparently no one wants to discuss it or vote on it either.
The motion has been made to move the question. The motion has been made to move the question, moved and seconded. Yes, I'm sorry.
That one is off.
Just to clarify, after I read this article, I asked if there was a motion on the floor to open this article for discussion. Am I correct in assuming that nobody made that motion? So there was no motion and there was no second. Well, that's what the motion is.
I would like to make a motion to put this on the floor for discussion.
The motion has been made by Commissioner Reid to put this article on the floor for discussion and seconded by Commissioner Ladd.
Can I speak, Commissioner?
Hold on.
Commissioner Reid.
I know we've had quite a few meetings on this. I hope people have seen it on television. We had a public hearing. We didn't get a lot of people there. Last year, I had concerns from different residents about parking situation, that there wasn't enough parking in the south part of the beach. I had concern from employers that the parking spots that were available were slowly disappearing. I had concern that there was that customers were not able to find affordable parking, and that people were coming to Hampton Beach and seeing the $40 and $50 parking lots and turning around and going over the bridge and leaving the beach. The purpose of the Village District is to promote Hampton Beach. The purpose of the Village District is to support the residents of the Village District. By doing this, I feel that we were offered this property by the Clues family. We were offered it at a, I believe, a fair market value. And by doing this, I think we're opening up an area where there isn't going to be a large condo, there's not going to be another restaurant, there's not going to be another bar, and we're going to be able to service the people, residents of Hampton Beach, businesses of Hampton Beach, and the guests of Hampton Beach. So I really hope that you work to make this go forward. Thank you.
Is there any further discussion on this article?
Hampton Beach area.
Name and address, please.
Timothy Jones, 16 Dustin Avenue, Hampton, New Hampshire, United States of America, planet Earth. The Hampton Beach Area Commission, chairman standing back there, did an independent study on the parking situation in Hampton Beach, including helicopters, maps, fairly sophisticated. The conclusion was there was no lack of parking at Hampton Beach. So, John Ninan, your commission is being laughed at. I'm merely stating the fact. The fact is the Hampton Beach Area Commission, of which Mr. Rage is a member, concluded that there was no parking problem. If there was a parking problem, why the Village District's representative at the Hampton Beach Area Commission, namely Commissioner Rage, didn't bring it up to the Hampton Beach Area Commission at any meeting is a bit of a curiosity. I acknowledge that. And even laughable. But I won't laugh, because this is a serious matter. The parking problem that was referred to is actually because certain people don't like people parking on their side streets, and the reason that people parking on their side streets is because that parking is free. Offering another lot to pay to park is not going to solve the problem. They're going to continue to seek free parking on the side streets. So that problem that he's referring to is not being addressed, even if it did exist. Furthermore, this particular property, as was testified in one of the Village District meetings earlier, was never put on the open market. And what we are now doing with this bond proposal is to go out and give the government the authority to go into the business of paying for parking, competing with the private sector. There are many people, several people, in this Village District that have parking lots. They earn a living from those parking lots. And now they have to compete with a government that will pay no property taxes, while the private sector is going to have to compete while paying those property taxes. No parking licensing fees, because they're the government. But the private sector, well, they have to pay those fees. So, unfair competition, absolutely. Now, I realize that we have been in the parking business before, but that was truly ancillary to simply having a fire station. We don't own this fire station. We own the old fire station. The only real reason this Village District existed was that fire station. The only legitimate government function that it performed was that, in my opinion. And it made sense that we had the extra land around the fire station to rent out those parking spaces. That made sense. It was simply an ancillary activity to owning the fire station. This is an out-and-out separate business that will compete with the private sector. Does it stop at parking lots? Will it next be a restaurant? Will it next be a motel? After all, we haven't built a motel in the Village District in quite a while.
I just built it.
Let's do a marina too. In fact, let's have all of the property at the Village District owned by the government, because the private sector doesn't know what to do with this land. The private sector never had an opportunity to compete and make a bid on this land. Not for one second was it available.
I'd like to make a
comment. And for this, it is clear intervention by the government preventing the private sector from putting this property to its highest and best use. Furthermore, the contingency on adopting 52, which is not legally sufficient in my opinion, renders this rather moot, but I'm not going to argue the legalities here because, well, that's best done in the courtroom. But the point is that the article that was passed in 1992 was equally insufficient legally speaking. It just hasn't been challenged yet. Thank you.
Is there anyone else who wishes to speak on this article? He's taller than you, Mike. He just walked by. Identify yourself, please.
Rick Griffin, 529 Ocean Boulevard. A lot of people here know their reasons why they might like this idea, and others may have reasons why they don't like it. But the reason I felt like I had to stand up and say something is, which is Mr. Jones just said, isn't true. The Clues property which they've had for many, many years, is they had a developer that is interested and built two houses already on other lots that they have that are adjacent to these lots. And they sold in a very short time in an area that no one thought that they could get almost $500,000 for the houses. The houses did sell. The developer is very good friends with the Clues, and they decided to step aside to let this be a possibility. Mr. and Mrs. Clues were my clients for probably 40 or 45 years, and they've always done a lot for Hampton Beach and the Village District. Mr. Clues was, I can't really remember exactly what, but an honorary fireman, a captain or something. He was a chief, honorary chief. He was always actively involved here. And he was a developer himself. When he had his house in Cambridge, Mass., he was one of the first people to really build condos there. So I think he always thought probably he would be building condos here, but I think he would be so thrilled to think that this is a possibility that could add something to Hampton that might be, you know, so valuable in the future as it is today. Thank you.
Anyone else? McGriff, identify yourself, please.
I want to be seen on camera. My green jacket with my green ticket. Tom McQuirk, 95 Ocean Boulevard. I do appreciate the comments that Citizen Jones, Tim Jones, had made, but I just wanted to give my opinion. Being a parking lot owner, my family is in the parking lot industry, and we take no offense that the precinct wants to be in competition with us. We actually don't find it to be in competition for the simple reason that each block on Hampton Beach needs to be serviced by parking. And this particular area doesn't have adequate parking for the density that they have in that area. Matter of fact, you know, I even spoke to Chuck when I saw her go into the newspaper. I emailed him, and I kind of joked, and I said, oh, you're trying to get in competition with me? And he says, oh, no, we're not in competition. And I was really just joking at that. I find that there is need. I find that this type of service is provided by municipalities and by precincts through the entire country. You find parking lots that are owned by Santa Monica, California, Portsmouth, New Hampshire, Worcester, Massachusetts. There are municipal parking lots everywhere. So I don't think that this is something that the precinct shouldn't investigate, quite honestly. I think that having this land is in perpetuity, which private lots are not in perpetuity. The McGuirk family could decide to sell their parking lots tomorrow if that's what they wanted to do. You know, we're not looking to do that. You know, we plan to be here for 100 more years. We've been here a very, very long time, and we take no offense that the precinct is going to be providing the same service that we do. They're not going to get into the restaurant business, another business that they were in. They're not going to get into the hotel industry, because those are not industries that government gets involved in. You know, and so that's my two cents regarding that. And the idea that you need to come up with a value by placing property on the open market is simply not the case. You know, value can be determined through professionals in the industry, appraisers or whatnot. And this, like Rick said, was something that was under agreement, you know, with the Clues family, with a reputable developer, one of the better developers in town. You know, so if he found value in the property in order to build the four houses, because I know it was very important to the Clues family that they did not want to disrupt the neighborhood. You know, Kathy Clues, you know, had mentioned to me that she didn't want big, huge hotels, big, huge condo developments in that neighborhood. It was very important to her. You could go and build a 50-foot tall hotel, 4 foot off the property lines, without a variance on that site. And that would disrupt Fellows Ave, that would disrupt Bragg Ave. So I think having open spaces in this particular area where we find single-family houses at low levels would actually improve the values of that neighborhood. Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
Mary Lamontagne, 186 Ashworth Avenue.
A little louder, please, for the recording clerk.
Mary Lamontagne, 186 Ashworth Avenue.
Thank you.
I own the Blue Jay Motel, which is just one block away from the Clues property. I grew up with the Clues, and Kathy and I have had many discussions about her property. And we're both looking, and the Blue Jay just went up for sale January 5th of this year. And Kathy and I have had many discussions, and we're talking about the moral compass of people that come into our properties. We've been here for many years, and it's not just about profit, and it's not just about building and changing the beach. It's about what's best for the precinct and the people of the beach. Down at the southern end of the beach, we don't have enough parking. I have the Blue Jay Motel on Ashworth Avenue. I own two houses on P Street. And I have adequate parking for my tenants, but not for their company. And I have, Blue Jay was built in 1951, so I have one car parking per unit, and it's adequate, but I have no extra. I send my people all the way up here to the precinct lot. They're happy to drive up here. They're happy to walk up here. They're happy to be up here just to have the parking. I think to have the parking down there would be an asset for all of us down at that end of the beach. White's Island, those cottages, they have no parking. They have either the state park or this parking lot. They have no parking. So I am very much in favor, and I think the Clues family has thought this through, and they're looking, they offered it to the precinct, and I think we'd be smart to take advantage of this opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. All right.
Mike Buckley, 6 Harris Ave. I just wanted to ask Stephen LaBranch a question. On the budget, it shows the parking lot revenue at $139,950. Is that correct?
We're not on the budget right now.
It goes to the point.
It puts the collateral information that you're looking for. Go ahead.
That is correct.
So we made $140,000 on that one parking lot. How much can the precinct make? And does any of that money offset taxes?
Yes.
The money that's generated from the parking lot goes to the offsets expenses in the cultural recreation portion of the budget. So yes, it does.
So it offsets
fireworks and pubs and things
like that.
That's right. Okay, thank you.
Okay, Mike?
Yeah.
Hi, Bob Preston, 339 Ocean Boulevard. I'm here as a member of the Hampton Beach Area Commission tonight. We had a vote last night, and we felt the long-term plan of Hampton Beach would benefit with more parking on the south end of the beach. The other speakers done a good job making all the points, so I don't need to rehash them. There was one thing on the parking study. We've had a lot of construction, a lot of new units that have been built, so we're using up these lots that we were used for parking before. And I think, you know, earlier we heard about things that they voted on in 1939 and 1992. I think if we look at ourselves as stewards of Hampton Beach and we say, what's the beach going to look like for our kids or our grandchildren? And I think the beach is better served if we have more parking down in that end of the beach. And if you don't mind, I think maybe we could vote to move the question.
Well, this is by ballot. Yes.
Now, we've had a couple of meetings where we discussed this, but I do want you to understand that the intent of this is that this will be paid for by a bond, 20-year-old, and the revenue that's generated from the lot will pay for the long-term taxes. That's the way we're doing this together.
Further discussion.
Brian Lapham, 27 I Street. I just wanted to make one quick comment. As Vice Chairman of the Budget Committee, we approved this by substance. We approved this. However, afterwards, it was said in the paper that, you know, we approved all the money articles. However, you'll see now, and I got several calls this afternoon, that we didn't. Well, it was because there was a wording change after we had voted. We couldn't re-vote again, so therefore, we couldn't endorse it. That's the only reason the Budget Committee is not shown on here as an endorsement. Brian Lapham, 27 I Street, regular person. Of the lease spaces, the one question I haven't seen to get an answer to, of the lease spaces, how many are going to go to the hotels or other people?
The lot will be run similar to the way this lot is run. It'll be a first-come, first-served basis. So.
Okay, but you don't have a number set aside as to how many, but you're just going to try to work that out.
Right.
All right. Thank you.
Yeah.
Anyone else?
Walter Kiplin, Penn Fellows Air. Motion to end discussion on the article.
Move the question.
Motion to move the question.
Do I have a second?
Second.
All right, a motion has been made and seconded to move the question. All signify by raising your green cards. The observation of the moderator indicates that the majority are ruled to move the question, which means that now we will go on to the vote on Article 2. And as I told you earlier, I mentioned earlier, because of the nature of this article, it has to be done by ballot. This is why it's important that you, now you're going to just allow me 5 minutes or so to set up the procedure for the balloting, and we'll get things flowing as best as possible. So just bear with me. Don't anybody move yet, please. Otherwise, we'll destroy the whole thing. So if you just give me a few minutes, we'll set this up to go on. Just one point, people. We are required to have the ballot. Excuse me. Just a moment, please. Because of the nature of the procedure that we have now for this article, it is necessary. Ballot voting on this article. Now, here's the procedure. All of you who have green cards, that certifies that you are a valid Hampton Beach Village District voter. I am asking you to queue up a line towards the back of the building, show your green card to the ballot clerk. Just show the green card. Necessary to show them an ID? Alright, I've been informed by the supervisor of the checklist that you have to show a valid picture ID, like a driver's license. You will be given a yes-no ballot, proceed to the voting booth, make your vote, move along to the left of that voting booth,
We're still required to keep the ballot box open for at least another 45 minutes. But while the process is going on, I am asking you, if you have voted to, please return to your seats so that we can continue with the process of voting on the rest of the warrant articles. So please return to your seats after you have voted and kind of calm down a little bit so we can continue.
Social atmosphere here, but we've got to move on. We've got a lot of work to do. Okay, I do have the results of the official ballot for commissioner for 3 years. Robert Ladd received 94 votes. Yoda Pino received 1. June White received 1. So I declare Robert Ladd as elected commissioner for 3 years. For treasurer for 1 year, Steve LaBranch, 90 votes, 1 write-in, Citizen Jones, 1 vote. I declare Steve LaBranch treasurer for the coming year. Moderator for 1 year, Richard Renio received 83 votes, Citizen Jones, 1 vote, Skip Windermiller, 1 vote. And I declare myself as moderator for the next year. Next office is clerk for 1 year. Janet Allard received 94 votes. Citizen Jones, 1 vote.
Oh, okay. All right, Citizen Jones, 1 vote. So I declare Janet Allard as our clerk for the next year. Supervisor of the checklist for 3 years. James Higgins, 93 votes. 93 votes. Citizen Jones, 1 vote. I declare James Higgins as supervisor of the checklist for a 3-year term.
So I want to
let's go on our business.
I want to do
one.
Do it, right?
No, you don't need to do
one.
As soon as the ballot,
excuse me, Mr. Moderator.
Yes.
Go ahead. All right, never mind.
Yes. Article 4.
That's not going to come out.
Please quiet down, please, so everybody can hear and participate. To see if the district will vote to accept the budget as submitted by the Budget Committee and to raise and appropriate the sum of $563,337 for district purposes in addition to any amounts that may be approved for special articles. Do I have a motion on Article 4?
Right.
Motion has been made by Michael Rumbley to open Article 4 for discussion. Do I have a second?
Second.
Article 4, yes.
Don't we have to wait until the other one has?
No.
The article is seconded by Ben Moore. All right, I will now open Article 4 for discussion.
I'm sorry, we need to wait until the budget is determined in order to be able to write into bond before moving on to the budget. Are you correct? So ask for a motion on another article. Thank you. Citizens' questions or something. Okay. I've just been informed that we have to set aside Article 4 just for the time being, and we'll move on to some of the other articles.
Article 5. Shall the Hampton Beach Village District accept the provisions of...
Richard, see if you can do the citizen petitions.
All right.
Okay.
Very well, very well. Let's get it.
Article 6 is citizens.
Mr. Moderator, I'd like to move to take Article 6 out of order.
Do I have a second?
Second.
All right. Motion to take Article 6 out of order.
Yes, I'm sorry. We have to withdraw the motion on Article... It was Article 3, right there? No. It was Article 4. All right, I'm looking for a motion to withdraw the motion on opening Article 4 for discussion. Oh, you're withdrawn, right? All right, will you withdraw? All right, so we're going to withdraw the motion on Article 4 for further discussion. Okay, let's go to now. I need a motion to move Article 6.
Wait, you got a vote on it.
The vote on the motion to withdraw.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Do I have a motion on withdrawing Article 4? And seconded. Uncle Buckley.
We're going to vote.
Uncle Buckley's motion, made the motion to withdraw. To take it out of order. Right? Is that correct?
Ask the recording secretary to please ask. Ask the recording, could you please state what motion is on the floor currently? And then to second.
You withdrew your motion.
Well, no, if the second is withdrawn, is that correct? Then the motion is then withdrawn. So he doesn't need to then withdraw it. You are all set.
Okay. Well, now we have to have an article. Motion to move from our sequence.
Yes, correct. Correct.
All right, now I will entertain a motion to move Article 6 out of sequence of the order that it is written. Do I have a motion to move Article 6 out of its existing law? Yes. Motion made by Mr. Buckley, seconded by Mr. Griffin.
She's on the table.
Now we are now it is out of sequence. We will now are reading, and then we will open it for discussion. On a petition of Una Pino and 25 other legal voters of the Hampton Beach Village District, shall the Hampton Beach Village District vote to raise and appropriate the sum of $2,000 in order to purchase and install an illuminated flagpole for flying the American flag at the precinct parking lot on the corner of Brown Ave and Ashworth Ave. The flag should be illuminated from sunset to sunrise. The commission has recommended this article. The budget committee recommended this article. Do I have a motion to open Article 6 for discussion? Name and address, please.
Paul Leonardo, 6 Fellows Ave.
Did you get this?
You had a motion. You did vote on the motion to move.
Yes, we did approve.
You didn't vote on
it. Oh, I'm sorry. All right, well, I need a motion to move Article 6 out of sequence. All those in favor, raise your hand. Article 6 is now moved out of sequence as it has appeared on the warrant. A motion has been made on Article 6 to open it for discussion.
Paul Leitano.
Paul Leitano. Address?
6
Fellows Ave.
Paul Leitano, R-E-I-T-A-N-O.
Second amendment, Rick Griffin. Any discussion on Article 6? Seeing no discussion, I am now calling for a vote on Article 6. All those in favor of Article 6 as it is written. The observation of the moderator indicates that the majority have voted in favor of Article 6. We'll move now to Article 7. On a petition of Luda Pino and 25 other legal voters of the Hampton Beach Village District, shall the Hampton Beach Village District vote to raise and appropriate the sum of $5,000 as a one-time donation to the Hampton Moving Wall Committee to help defray the cost of bringing the Vietnam Veterans Memorial Moving Wall to Hampton Beach. The commissioners recommend this article. The budget committee recommends this article.
Do I have a motion to open Article 6 for discussion? Motion made by Rick Griffin, seconded by Walter Kevlin, to open Article 6 for discussion. Is there any discussion now on Article 6? I'm sorry, Article 7.
Brian Lappin, 27 High Street. I think, in my own opinion, the town dropped the ball on this one. I would hope that you would please do this for Uta. She has spent a lot of time. She's worked very hard to get this through. I know some of the details need to be done out, but that's still 2 years away. That's it. Thank you.
Yeah. Anybody else?
Oh. All right, second for a vote.
No, he's not. Mike, no, he's not. You just need to speak.
Good evening, everybody. I'd like to take a brief moment to give you some of the thoughts and ideas. Oh, I'm sorry. Eileen DeBoer, Harris Ave, Hampton Beach. Thank you so much. As you know, every year the commissioners sit down with the activities coordinator and sometimes just an informal get-together is, what can we do this year to make some kind of an improvement on what already exists? Or perhaps, what can we do that might be new and a good thing for Hampton Beach and the people who live here? And it, many of you probably see the articles in the paper where we have the surfing for wounded warriors up at North Beach, and that has taken on extremely well. And there's a week at the end of the summer, the week preceding Labor Day, that seems to die off. People have to get their kids home and ready for school. And the thought was to tie in the project of the moving wall into this week where there's less noise, less chaos, maybe less of the kids, you know, running around and doing their thing, and perhaps have a quiet week to be able to reflect on our veterans who have passed on, not just only in Vietnam, but through all the wars. And I'm sure everyone in this room has a family member or two or more that was lost in our protecting our country. And we thought this would be an excellent opportunity. I didn't do it. Because of the fact that it is a quieter week, and it's a week that would show respect to these veterans. And I hope you will consider it. I, too, am very sorry that the town voted it down. I don't feel very patriotic when a town votes something like that down. However, this is the Village District, and I hope you will vote for it. Thank you.
Any further discussion? Fred Rice, then Michael. Identify yourself, Fred, please.
Thank you, Mr. Moderator. Fred Rice, 15 Heather Lane. I'm sitting over in the alien section over here. But thank you for letting me speak. I think most people here know that when this came up before on the warrant for the town of Hampton, that I spoke strongly against it. Good news is, down here, I'm going to speak strongly for it. There's a very distinct reason why it's two different positions. I don't think that it's appropriate for money to be taken from people that may not all necessarily want to participate, to do something that's going to benefit just a small portion. Mainly, it's going to benefit the tourists that come here. They're going to get a chance to see it. The fact of the matter is, the people from uptown are not going to try and drive down here, try and find a parking space and walk a half a mile to come up and see something in the middle of a bunch of tourists. Some of you may remember that several years ago, this moving wall was up at Pease, and they had it at a very quiet place. It was out by itself, and there were hundreds, if not thousands, of people that went through there almost on a daily basis. It was there for several days. The people that put this thing on, to them it's a business. It's a bunch of guys with a semi-truck, and they got racks that they move these panels in and out of. And the price is $20,000. I think that's $20,000 every single week for them. From the people that are sponsoring, from my perspective, there's two ways you can look at it. One, it can be a labor of love where you work your butt off to to raise the money to pay them their $20,000. Or you can say that it is part of your advertising and promotion budget here in the beach. In either one of those cases, I would support that 100%. Now, as for the wall itself, I've got probably a closer connection to that wall than most people do. I've got about 15 of my classmates from West Point that are on that wall. I've got the best sergeant that was in my outfit on my second tour in Vietnam who was on that wall. Those of you who know how it's fixed, it starts in the middle and goes to the right, and then comes around and the other side, and it ends right next to where it starts. It's the symbolism of it. If you go on the first panel, about 10 or 12 rows down, the guy that lived across the hall from me at West Point is there on the very first panel. You're going to be a long ways before you get off to, the second panel. There's not many people died in those early days. That panel means an awful lot to me. And I definitely support the wall. The issue is not whether I support the wall or anybody else supports the wall. The issue is how you fund it. And if you choose as a political body to fund this, to vote for this, as part of your advertising and promotion budget, because it definitely will help the beach by the tourism, that's fine. I would support that 100%. The other part is, as far as I know, there has not been a date selected that's specific yet. There's not been a location that's specific and appropriate. Don't throw this thing out in the middle of the midway out here. That's not the idea. If you're going to show reverence to the people who died in Vietnam, let's put it in a place where you can have that reverence, not out in the middle of ice cream and popcorn and kids on the beach. That's not the appropriate place for it. The date, the time, who's going to do all this stuff, that should be all in there. I know a little bit about that stuff. I spent 4 years of my life working on the gazebo committee uptown to raise the $120,000 that it took to fund that. There weren't very many people who spent all 4 years, myself and Bob Labonte, were the only two. A lot of other people came and went. I know the amount of work that goes into it, but if it's something you want and you truly want to honor somebody, you do the work to do it. You don't just put your hand up and say, give it to me out of tax. Having said that, I'll go back to this again. If you want to make it an advertising expense, I would support that 100%. I understand it's a possibility that somebody may step forward and fund the whole thing. If they do that, good for them. That's all the better for the precinct and everything else. So I would strongly support this the way it is worded for just the precinct. For the town, no. For the precinct, absolutely yes. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Moderator, I listened carefully to you.
Identify yourself, please. Name and address.
I'm the same Timothy Jones at 16 Dustin Avenue. Are you going to allow me to introduce myself or not? I am the same Timothy Jones of 16 Dustin Avenue that you heard of before. I listened to Mr. Rice's little talk tonight. I'm on the Budget Committee, as some of you know. We listened to him in public comment on the town's budget, in which he was very compelling and telling us how it's not a good thing to compel people to pay taxes for what he perceived to be a voluntary effort. And I agreed with him then. But the fact that he's doing a flip on this is really confusing because, yeah, it's still a tax, Fred. It's a tax. And taxes, as you know, are compulsory. And now you're advocating that the compulsory tax here at the Village District, where you don't pay taxes, is okay, but it's not okay in the town where you do pay taxes. I'm a bit confused by your argumentation, Fred. It didn't make a lot of sense to me. I do believe that Uta is going to be speaking next, and I don't want to chew up any more time than necessary, but the key point here for the Village District, in my opinion, is that Uta had gave testimony at one of the Village District meetings a month or two ago that she has a private person that's willing to fund the entire effort privately. That's a voluntary effort. And I see no reason why the government should step in what is supposed to be a wall of freedom and kind of like undermine that freedom by making it compulsory taxes, especially when we have someone that's willing to pay for the whole thing. So that's it. Thank you.
Good.
Hi, my name is Uta Pino, 15 Tudor Ave. I was the one who brought the article forward. I thought to have the wall in the middle of the beach where the sand desk is would be a great place. I have so much stuff going on in my personal life, I did not read the paperwork correctly. The wall cannot be set up on concrete. It has to be on grass. It was my mess up. I didn't read the whole thing. I went to Diana from the town. Diana suggested, since Tuckfield is taken over Monday through Friday for games for the kids and for grown-ups, we cannot use it. School is out of the question because they start in August to use the fields for sports. She suggested we use the Church Street parking lot. There is grass, it's fenced in, it's protected, there is, it's easy in from the town, easy out, no parking issues, and it's secure, it's grass, we can park up front and we can set up the wall. I also talked with Gino from Ports and Harbor last year, and he suggested I can have the green space as you come over the bridge. It might look good, but once you come over the bridge, then people are so confused. I think it's a hazard, because then they would guard what's going on, and we would have one accident after another. So the only places right now in this town is the Church Street parking lot or the state park itself.
The green space across from the church, by Church Street, it's all enclosed.
That's the Church Street parking lot. That's a parking lot. The town leases it from the church. As far as the wall cost is, the cost is $8,208. That does not include insurance, does not include flyers, flags, if you want to put up the marsh stuff, does not include, you cannot eat, drink, smoke, or have animals around the wall. So up front is out. Like I said, I screwed up, I did not read the paperwork all the way through. So the Church Street parking lot is good for State Park, and there is no other place in town where you could have it that's big enough, where you can park, set it up. I mean, the wall is 300 feet long. Where do you want to set it up? There's no room. Even the old town hall and the playground out there is not big enough. And I hope you guys support it. And either way, it's going to come. Thank you.
Anybody else?
Is there any further discussion on Article 7? Seeing none, I am going to ask for a vote. All those in favor of Article 7, please signify by raising your cards. In the opinion of the moderator, the majority has voted in approval of Article 7.
I need a motion now to move Article 5 out of sequence.
I'll make that motion.
Motion has been made by Chuck Ray, seconded by Rick Griffin, to move Article 5 out of sequence. All's in favor? The motion has been made and seconded to move Article 5 out of sequence. Now, I'm going to read the article, and then we'll talk about opening for discussion. Shall the Hampton Beach Village District accept the provisions of RSA 31:95-B, providing that any village district at any annual meeting may adopt an article authorizing indefinitely until specific recession of such authority, the commissioners to apply for, accept, and expend without further action by the village district meeting unanticipated money
from a state, federal, or other governmental unit, or a private source which becomes available during the fiscal year. The commissioners recommended this article. Do I have a motion and a second on Article 5 as it is written? Motion has been made by Rick Griffin and seconded by Eileen Jenna Lewis. We got them both? I will now open Article 5 for discussion. Is there any discussion on Article 5? Legal counsel is going to speak on this article.
Thank you. Article 5 is somewhat similar to Article 3 in that it's basically it's a housekeeping matter. This issue arose after the bond article was presented to the Budget Committee, and a question was raised as to whether or not the commissioners had the authority to basically seek this money. So, again, out of an abundance of caution, because it wasn't readily apparent when this the warrant was being prepared, whether or not we had done this in the past, we put this warrant article on. As it turns out, the precinct has in fact already passed this warrant article several years ago. So this really is redundant, and the only thing that I would recommend that you do, again, in order to simply be consistent, is to vote for it, and there's going to be no further action that's going to be required. It is significant because it will, if the bond article is authorized, it will enable the commissioners to go forward and make the arrangement for the bond. I'd be happy to answer any questions that you may have.
Any other discussion? I'd like to make a motion to move the question.
Second. Motion has been made by Chuck Rage to move the question, seconded by Walter Kevlin. The question is now moved. We will now take a vote on Article 5. All those in favor of moving the question? All right, I see that there is more than a two-thirds vote to move the question. The question is now moved. We will now vote on Article 5. All those in favor of Article 5 as it is written, signify by raising the cards. In the opinion of the moderator, the majority has voted in favor of Article 5. All right. Article 4. I need a motion to now move Article 4 out of sequence.
We can't do it until we find out.
Can we do it to discuss it? We can open up Article 4 for discussion. People can ask questions about Article 4. We cannot vote on Article 4 until the ballots are counted.
Not yet. We have to wait. We still have another 15 minutes. It's required to keep the ballot box open for at least an hour. We started at 8:05, so we have to go to 9:05. To keep everything legal. Yes, Mr. Kevlin.
During this moment where there's a loss, I'd like to show our appreciation to the silent force of the Hampton Beach Commission, Secretary Joan Rice.
Actually, on the same note, Walter, along that line of congratulations and appreciation, I would like to say thank you to Channel 22 for being here tonight and working on taping this our annual meeting, and also for the time and effort that they spend on our weekly meetings. So again, thank you to the board of Channel 22.
So do we want to discuss it? So we're going to open up the discussion.
Okay. Either we get that or a few announcements out of the way, we are now going to open up Article 4 for discussion. Is there anyone who wants to speak on Article 4? Yes.
Article 4 is this, I gotta read it first. Yeah, we're gonna read it, then I'm gonna ask for a motion.
Read it again.
Article 4, to see if the district will vote to accept the budget submitted by the Budget Committee and to raise and appropriate the sum of $563,337 for district purposes in addition to any amounts that may be approved by special articles. Again, right now, we are opening this up. Do I have a motion to open up Article 4 for discussion? Motion made by Rick Griffin and seconded by Arlene Jennings to open and second Article 4 for discussion. Does anyone have any discussion on Article 4?
Move the question.
We can't vote on it yet.
Mr. Moderator, why can't you vote on it now?
Because we're required to keep the ballot box open for at least 1 hour, and the results of that balloting will have some effect on the discussion of this article.
Could you help me with what that is?
Chuck, you want to address it?
I just want to explain why we have to wait. If this article passes that we're waiting for, then we have to adjust the budget. We have to adjust the budget for income that's coming in, and we have to adjust the budget for money that will be spent. So, until we know the results of that article, we can't do the budget. So we just have to wait another few minutes. So if anybody wants to discuss what's in the budget now, I'm glad to answer any questions.
Thank you. The way that it's worded, though, it's really that it's open-ended. You can raise the $500,000 plus anything else. So, I mean, we could vote on this now, and still, it may not be included whether or not it happens.
The reason being is we're going to have to staff the parking lot. We're going to have to accept the money that comes in has to go to the budget. So you can't just take money that's not, you can't spend money that you haven't approved. So
sure.
We have to staff the parking lot. We need to be able to have it in our budget.
I think I can ask you a question. The way that Article 5 is written, and it has to be written this way, is that the operating budget is $563,337.
75.
You vote on that plus any what's called a special article, and a special article, for example, is the one that we just voted on with Uta's citizen petition, in which there was a certain small amount of money that was appropriated for certain specific tasks. That's what's called a special article. So in Article 5, which we're talking about right now, that's the general operating budget, and that's voted on separate and apart from these special items. What Chuck was just referring to is that if the budget, if the bond article is voted yes, if that passes, then the general operating budget that's referenced here in Article 5 may need to be amended in order to include certain things that Chuck has referenced. Okay?
Yes. Ben Moore, 375 Ocean Boulevard. A little confused. We vote on expenditures, I believe, unless the district is different than a town. So the revenues are the revenues. Those are in, and they are part of the tax rate setting that occurs much later in the year. I wasn't here for most of the winter, thank God. Has there been discussion in the prior public hearings regarding the additional operating expenses that you'd expect to incur over and above the principal and interest payments that might happen in 2015?
I don't believe so.
Can we discuss that now, awaiting the vote?
All right, so the bond...
Can I be with the box?
The bond, we're looking at a top figure of approximately $95,000. We've had quotes, estimate quotes from $75,000 to $95,000. It depends on the interest rate that we get. It depends on the term that we get and the best deal for the village district. So when we go to negotiate this, we need to have enough money into the budget to pay this bond. So if we put in another $95,000, that will
that we believe is more than enough to cover where we're at. We also need expenses of payroll and expenses of supplies. So we're putting in higher amounts into payroll. Right now, payroll for running the, it's 4589-A, if you look on the budget. Well, Stephen, just wait one second, please. We are looking at, it's a smaller area, and it's not going to be open as much as that. We're looking at adding another approximately $15,000. So.
Yes.
Yeah.
And let me explain something for you. If you look in the book, look on page 12, okay? And you'll see under, on the left hand column, you have your account number. Your account number 4589-3, and you'll see parking lot. There's a K for the payroll, B for the supplies, C for marketing. As you can see, I put some marketing. Depending on how this vote turns out, that dollar is going to have to be changed. They have to have the money in the budget to be able to pay for the line. So just need a little more of an explanation. So if you look in the book, you can follow along a little easier.
Ben Moore, 375 Ocean Boulevard. The $75,000 to $95,000, I've already voted yes for the damn $1,000, but you guys, I'm surprised you guys didn't talk about this earlier. Are you going to be making one payment before the end of calendar 2015? Or is it going to be one for a whole year of P&I, or are you going to be making it every 6 months? Because if you are, then only half of that $75,000 to $95,000 should be included in this budget. And what was the exact number of the additional operating costs associated with the operation? $15,000?
$15,000 is
that's it. So you'll be modifying the budget.
Payroll, and then we're modifying supplies from $2,000 to $3,500 for new signage.
So it's through the math, $16,000 of additional operating costs plus whatever P&I effect you have in calendar year 2015.
Yeah.
Thanks.
And Mr. Moore, just as a procedural question too, the last report whether this had been discussed. I do know that at the public hearing on February 11th, I believe it was, a lot of these same issues were discussed.
Okay, good. Well, that's important. I'm sorry.
Thank you.
John, do you want to discuss on the payment? Can you add to that?
Well, I recognize Mr. Jones first.
No, you did. All right.
If I may, Mr. Moderator, through you to the Treasurer. Could you tell us how much excess was available in last year's budget?
Unexpended?
Yes.
On page 4 of the if you look at the last line, it says unexpected from 2014 that will be used to offset that to be raised in 2015. $39,547.58.
So essentially $40,000 left over from last year.
If you want to round it up, yes.
And you're looking to add how much if the, well not if, but when the bond passes, when the bond warrant article passes, how much you plan on increasing the budget?
Our attorney said that we should put the higher number. There are a couple of options that John Payne was going to explain. And she said that we should put the higher number.
What is that number?
$95,000.
Okay. Mr. Moderator, I move we add $95,000 to the budget.
Can I get a second?
No. Mr. Moderator, there's a motion and a second. Move to add $95,000. Second
is John, Mr. Buck. Does the clerk have the recording secretary have the names of those who made the motion and the second?
Uh,
All right, there's a motion on the floor to add $75,000 to the budget. To add $95,000 to the budget. A motion has been made and seconded.
Sharon, can we do pending the results of the vote?
All those in favor of a motion to raise the appropriation for the Hampton Beach Village District budget by $75,000. $95,000. The 75 sounds better. Please signify by raising your cards. All right, I think we're going to have to take a count. Please hold your cards up.
No,
the motion is on the floor now. Is basically an amendment to the original motion. So all those in favor, I'll open up the amendment for discussion.
Yeah.
To add $95,000 to the bottom line of the budget.
Discussion?
Open for discussion.
Brian Martin, 27 I Street. I don't understand how, again, we're kind of jumping ahead here. I don't understand how we can add the $95,000 when we don't even know everything was approved. If it wasn't approved, I don't want to add $95,000. I'm sorry, but I prefer to wait a few more minutes, and then once that's clarified, then we can go on with it. Thank you.
Is there any more discussion on the amendment?
Helena Barthel, 33 Dover Avenue. I was just, if we're going to estimate that the expenses are going to go up $95,000, well, wouldn't we also be estimating that the revenue from the parking lot is going up $95,000? So shouldn't the amount of the budget that we vote for stay the same? Because whatever it's going to cost us, supposedly we're getting that in revenue from the parking fees. So I don't want to vote for an extra $95,000 in a budget because I thought the increase in revenues would be taking care of that.
The Budget Committee could speak to this better than I but
add more, 375 Ocean Boulevard. You have to budget for gross expenditures. That we all, I think, you know, if you followed New Hampshire RSAs, you have to budget for gross expenditures. So I understand the reason for the 95, whether it's premature or not, I do not want to comment on, but you do have to budget for gross expenditures. Revenues makes no difference in this world.
You can't spend it less than the budget.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
Could you ask John Kane to come up and spend a few minutes explaining how the bond works while we're waiting to take this vote?
We have a motion on the floor on this amendment.
You opened it up for discussion, didn't you?
Right, but where is any further discussion?
Can you speak for it? John Kane?
Second.
You have a second? All right, a motion has been made and seconded to vote on the amendment. All those in favor of taking the vote, please raise your cards. All those opposed to voting on the amendment. Wait a minute. You're voting opposition to vote on the amendment.
The voting against adding $95,000.
right now.
All right.
Before, it's premature.
That's not your vote, you voted the question. No, that isn't what he said. There is a motion to amend the budget by $95,000. Another motion was made to vote on the on that amendment. I am asked, and the motion has been moved. So I am asking now for those who are in favor of the amendment to add $95,000 to the budget. All those in favor of that amendment, raise your cards. All I see is four cards. All those opposed to the amendment. One, two.
Where are your cards? Where's your cards?
So wait a second. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. There are 36 votes against the amendment, so the amendment fails.
Huh? Time for that. Time to go. That's good.
Yep. Yep. All right, it is now 9:05.
The secretary has a question for you.
Right. There are, that's right. There was the no vote was to vote against the amendment.
This gentleman is standing with the card.
Yes, sir. All right, just hold out just 5 minutes. The ballot box, or the ballots, the polls have now closed for the yes-no vote on the article. So if you just bear with me for 10 minutes or so that we can open up the ballot box and make the count. All right, 5 minutes.
Are we in recess?
No,
don't go anywhere. Are we in recess?
That man thought we were close. I said, oh, we have, and then we wanted to continue discussion, and everybody kind of, just a few minutes ago,
continuing discussion, and if the bond article passes, then we can talk about amending the budget to add the $95,000.
Right.
And can someone please, from here, just do it? You know, you make the motion, or Bob, or Chuck?
To continue discussion on it?
No, you don't need to continue discussion. That's a given. To amend the operating budget to add on the 95.
Appreciate it. Thank you, Rim. Give yourselves a round of applause just because you're so wonderful. Thank you again. He's right there. Chuck? I don't know. I want you. I always want you.
You back? Call the meeting back to order, please. The results of the ballot voting on Article 2 as required, there were 75 votes cast. There were 69 yes votes and 6 no votes for a total of 75.
Yay!
For Article 2 passes, Article 2 passes as with. So now we can pick up.
I would like to make a motion to amend the operating budget.
Wouldn't be by 95,000.
It's a
little
start. I don't think so. And item, line item 4589-3C. Did I correct Stephen?
Yes.
I'd like to amend it to 95,000. Can I do them all together? All right, item 4589-B. I'd like to change that to 3,500.
Go back a second here. We're on the payroll stays the same. 35.
We're at parking lot, 4589-3.
Right.
So A is I haven't got to that one yet.
A is,
we're gonna amend that to 45.
That's payroll.
Payroll.
Right. That's gonna go to 45.
B, we're gonna go to 3,500. And C to 95,000.
That's the bond thing.
That will be a total of $111,500. That will change the bottom line of the budget from $563,337 to $674,837. What's the difference?
Give the gentleman time to clear it up for you instead of interrupting. Guys.
$111,500 to be in spent for this year. The new total would be $674,837. And the motion is presently on the floor, and it has been seconded.
Who seconded the motion?
I did.
Okay, Michael Buckley seconded the motion on the amendment. Is there any discussion on the amendment? We didn't know what the figure was.
I'd like to ask one question.
Go ahead, Ben.
Benmore, 375 Ocean Boulevard. The tax rate setting is what the approved expenditures are, less whatever your estimated revenues are at that time when you submit for the tax rate. You're going to add the maximum amount of expenditure that you can possibly forecast in 2015. All I would ask is whether the commissioners are prepared to use the surplus that exists at the precinct in case that bond payment is less than $95,000 in 2015, that you're prepared to go to use other measures to make sure that it economically makes sense as far as what your cash flow will be in 2015. Are the commissioners shaking their heads that they understand what I'm talking about?
I do.
Yes.
I do.
Thank you.
We'll pay our bills.
Thanks.
Is there any further discussion on the amendment?
I want to just make a quick point. Is the budget is always set at a certain level because you have to have money in your budget to, you have to have it there to make me to spend it. And every year, we put back money that isn't spent. And this year, we didn't spend $39,547.58, which will go back to offset taxes in 2015. I'm hoping, and the three commissioners that are here, we are very frugal. We do not spend money that we don't have to spend. And I'm hoping that this is going to be a lot less than that. And last year we had the same discussion about $10,000 that we added in for the parking lot where we use funds, special revenue funds. We did not go over that amount, and it was in the budget. We don't do that. And there's a history of the three of us that we don't spend money. You know, you hear of a lot of towns of December, the last week of December, they're running around trying to spend whatever's in their budget. We don't do that. And I promise you as a commissioner, and I'm up for election next year, I am not doing that. Thank you.
Is there any further discussion on the amendment? Seeing none, is there a motion to amend Article 4 to increase the bottom line budget of the village precinct? All right, the line items were in the amendment were 4589-3 under parking to increase under payroll to 45,000. That's correct? All right. Article supplies and improvement to increase by, what's the figure?
3,500.
Article C, the bond payment, from $1 to $95,000. Is that correct?
Yep.
Is everybody clear on that? All right, I'll accept the motion on the total amendment that totals $111,500. Is that correct?
Yes.
Motion has been made and moved to raise the bottom line budget of $111,500 now of a figure of $674,837. All those in favor? All those opposed? It's the opinion of the moderator that the bottom line budget has been approved by the majority of those present for $674,837.
Richard, you have a...
check with the other business.
I have a motion to support the amendment regarding parking lot revenue on page 6. To amend it to represent the expected revenues from 2016 for said parking lot. I don't know what the number should be. And I would expect the number to be available from the board here. But I think the motion to amend parking lot revenue or revenues to be obtained from the lot.
Well, we need a figure. Actually, sir, we have already voted on the bottom line of...
That's expenditure, not revenue.
Are you looking at revenue?
I'm talking revenue money, 34, 86. There's revenue that's expected in, that's been offset by the expenditure.
How can we vote on something that's not what if you don't get the income?
Now, just to clarify, we have already voted on the bottom line expenditure budget. If you want to amend and project maybe additional income over and above what is already projected, that does not affect the bottom line figure of the operating budget. I'm going to let the our council address that issue.
All right. What the voters, what the legislative body votes on is whether or not you raise and appropriate a certain sum. You have done that. Okay? Now, if you as a group of as the legislative body also want to instruct your commissioners to amend or revise their official MS-37, their budgetary internal documents that they keep in order to reflect what the anticipated revenue is for the new parking lot, that's fine. But that would be a separate action which I would recommend to be taken, for example, under the catch-all articles on Article 8, which is to transact any other business that may legally come before this meeting. It would be an instruction. And just make it an instruction to the commissioners. All right.
We already did.
No.
On the bottom line?
You have voted on the bottom line.
Right. So
we've completed all the warrant articles. Just heard.
Yeah, that's fine.
All right. All right, the next item on the agenda, on the warrant, is Article 8. To transact any other business that may legally come before this meeting. Does anyone have any other business to bring before the meeting? I'll repeat it again. Does anyone have any other business to bring legally before this meeting?
No.
I don't.
That man is.
Wait a minute.
The man said no, because he's not doing it.
There's been no discussion on Article 8. I move to adjourn. I make the motion to move the question.
There is no question because.
We have to move on Article 8 first.
May I make one announcement first? I go, the Blue Ocean Society, which is right up on Ocean Boulevard, on this coming Tuesday is having an open house from 5 to 7 p.m., and you are all invited to attend. A motion has been made to adjourn. Do I have a second on the motion to adjourn? A motion made by Commissioner Rage, seconded by Mike Buckley. All those in favor of adjourning?
Yes.
All those opposed? This meeting is now adjourned at 9:23. Thank you all for coming.